What's up, guys? It's Mr. iPod coming in here with a little lesson recap for lesson 4.3 homework. Now, this is actually my second time making this video because the first time after recording the whole thing, it did not drop. Some technical difficulty. So if this doesn't work out, I'm going to have to give it up for the night. So I have 10y equals 2x plus 2. I'm just going to start with the first one. Now, most of you were here during the lecture. I know some people left or wasn't here during lecture. So the lecture portion on this side, this is what you were missing as far as the notes. Basically, we're graphing by solving for the x and y intercepts and then graphing the x and y intercepts. So to solve for the y intercept, substitute 0 for the x and solve for y. To solve for the x-intercept, substitute 0 in for y and solve for x. Okay, so it's pretty simple. I'm going to use a couple of different colors to kind of show you the difference in the x and the y-intercept. Okay, so I'm just going to start with number 1, and then I'll work just a few more. So looking at this one, again, my main goal is to find the x-intercept, the coordinate point of the x-intercept, and then to also find the y-intercept's coordinate point. Okay, so should be pretty easy. The first step I got to do is I'm going to rewrite the problem. So 10y equals 2x plus 20. Now the first step in doing this, in solving for the x-intercept, is to substitute 0 in for the y. Because on the x-intercept, where a line crosses the x-intercept, the y-coordinate is 0. So I can tell you right now that this y-coordinate right here is going to be 0. Because where a line intercepts the x-intercept, the your y-coordinate will be 0. So basically, we got to say 10 times 0 equals 2x plus 20. And then from there, we just solve. So 10 times 0 is 0 equals 2x plus 20. From here, you just solve for 2x. So I'm going to subtract 20 from both sides, canceling, leaving me with negative 20 equals 2x. And then from there, I divide both sides by 2, and I get x is equal to negative 10. So my x-coordinate would be negative 10. So check this. When y is 0, x is negative 10. So that creates a coordinate point, negative 10, 0, also known as the x-intercept. Now for the y-intercept, you rewrite the problem. You start with the same. Rewrite the problem. 10y equals 2x plus 20. And then what you're going to do is, instead of substituting 0 for y this time, we're going to substitute 0 for x. Because where a line intersects the y-axis on a graph, the x-coordinate is 0. So we really just got to find the y, okay? So 10y equals 2 times 0. The x is 0. Keep in mind the x is 0 plus 20. So that just cancels out, leaving me with 10y equals 20. Divide both sides by 10, and that would leave you with y equals 2. So 2, 0. So this is the answer I'm looking for problems 1 through 4. I'm just looking for the x and y intercepts. You don't have to graph them or anything like that. Okay. Now, when I go down here to number 4, just to kind of look at number 4 with you, negative x plus 4 equals negative 4y. So the first thing I'm going to do is I need to solve for the x and the y intercept. So I'm going to solve for the x intercept, something, comma, something, and I'm going to solve for the y intercept, which is something, comma, something. Oops, sorry. Didn't mean to do that. Something, comma, something. All right. So to solve for the x, I'm going to rewrite the problem. Negative x plus 4 equals negative 4y. Okay. In order to solve the x-intercept, I have to substitute 0 in for y. So negative x plus 4 equals negative 4 times 0. This cancels on this side, leaving me negative x plus 4 equals 0. Now I just got to isolate x. I'm going to do that by adding x to both sides. That cancels, leaving me with 4 equals x. So I know my x is 4, my x-intercept is 4, comma, 0. Why is it 4, comma, 0? Because when y is 0, x is 4. Okay, now going to the y-intercept portion of this, I rewrite the problem. Negative x plus 4 equals negative 4y. All right, so when I'm looking at this right here, instead of substitute 0 for y, for the y-intercept, I got to do the opposite. Substitute 0 in for x, just like this. And then I'm left with this. This just cancels out, leaving me with 4 equals negative 4y. Divide both sides by negative 4. I know I'm kind of going through fast, but slow me down. Y equals 4 divided by negative 4 is negative 1. So my y, when x is 0, that's x, y was what? Negative 1. And that's just a little error right there. So again, this is my answer. Okay? Now going to number 5, which is where we kind of start with the graphs. Looking at number 5. Again, you're doing the same thing, but this time you're going to graph it. All right? So I'm going to rewrite. So again, my main objective, I need to find the x-coordinate, the x-intercept, excuse me, and the y-intercept. Well, to find the x, I rewrite the problem. Negative 30 equals 16x minus 6y. In order to find the y-intercept, follow the steps. Substitute 0 in for y. So negative 30 equals 16x minus 6 times 0. Because I'm hunting for that x-intercept. This just cancels, leaving me with negative 30 equals 16x. So I divide both sides by 16. And I get x is equal to... Now, this is where I kind of saw an issue. I was trying to get it where they're all whole numbers, but obviously that wouldn't work here. So we're just going to keep this as that fraction, negative 30 over 16. So my x-intercept, x was negative 30 over 16 when y was 0. Now, keep this in mind. Some of you don't know. I mean, obviously I wouldn't know how to graph 30 over 16, but change that to a decimal and you would get 1.875. Okay, 1.875, so you guys know how to change that to a decimal. So then it's going to be negative. So I need to put a point on the graph at this, which would be just right here. Okay, now to go find the y-intercept, I'm going to rewrite the problem. Negative 30 equals 16x minus 6y. So I'm going to substitute 0 in for x this time in order to find y. So negative 30 equals 16 times 0 minus 6y. Again, that cancels, it just gives us 0. And then I can divide both sides by negative 6 by doing the inverse operations. Y equals a negative divided by negative is a positive. 30 divided by 6 is 5. So my y-intercept is 0, 5. Because when x is 0, y is 5. When x is 0, y is 5. So plot that point, and then you'll get your straight edge, and you will graph that point. I graph the line, and then obviously you can kind of tell from there if you follow your slope here, and you should be able to follow it again. It's going to get you near the same kind of point there. I'm going to label it negative 30 equals 16x minus 6y. I got time for one more problem. Okay, one more problem. I'm going to go down here to number 8, and then I'll leave you with the backside. So first, I need to find the x. And the x-intercept and the y-intercept. Okay. So first, I'm going to start with the x. So I'm going to rewrite the problem. 4x equals 4 plus 2y. So in order to find the x-intercept, substitute 0 in for y. So 4x equals 4 plus 2 times 0. That cancels. Divide both sides by 4, and I get x is equal to 1. So my x-intercept 1 comma 0 because when y was 0. X is 1, 1 comma 0. Now going to the y, I'm going to rewrite the problem. 4x equals 4 plus 2y. Okay, and then I substitute 0 in for x in order to find the y. I do this. That cancels. 0 equals 4 plus 2y. I subtract both sides by 4. Cancels. 2y equals negative 4. Therefore, leading me division, inverse operations, and I get negative 2. So my y-intercept is negative 2 comma 0. So now I'm going to plot both those points. That one worked out real nice. So I got negative 2, 0, and 1, 0. And then I'm going to use my straight edge, and I'm going to graph this point. Try to get it as in the middle of those lines as you can. And then I have 4x equals 4 plus 2y. Okay. I think you guys can handle the rest. If you need help, let me know. I'm obviously looking at 14. 14 has a fraction. Don't be afraid of that fraction. Just get rid of that fraction by multiplying both sides by the LCM of the denominator. So don't be afraid of that. Don't come in here tomorrow with this blank. Work it out. Try to figure it out, okay? I want to see you figure that out, okay? And then the rest, I think you guys can handle just following those steps. Hey, this is Mr. Ipok. I appreciate your time. Love you guys to death. Have a good night.